Bonjour, bienvenue au French Tech Podcast. Welcome to the French Tech Podcast. We're still here at Big Data World with our guest, Shafiq Rab. Could we ask you to please introduce yourself, Shafiq?
Yeah, mon nom, my name is Shafiq, S-H-A-F-I-Q. I am the Senior Vice President and Chief Information Officer for Rush University System for Health in Rush University in Chicago, Illinois.
And what do you do in that role?
So I'm the Chief Digital Enterprise CIO. So my role includes transformation of healthcare and serving the constituents from patients to community to nurses and doctors so that we enable their work by using technology.
And what's an example of something, a recent project that you did?
Well, lots of examples. One of the examples is that you can have care whenever you want it, wherever you want it, by doing virtual e-visits on demand, or you can scan a blood product by using just an iPhone, or you can improve the quality of care by making sure people wash their hands, at the same time encouraging people to use data and technology to understand healthcare better. For example, if somebody comes into the emergency room or ED, a lot of people leave the ED, we can now predict which three people will leave. So we go and make sure that they are taken care of, a newspaper, a cup of coffee, or something like that.
Well, that's interesting. That's how you keep them there.
Well, we don't want them to leave without getting care because they'll end up, something serious might happen, you know.
Yeah.
After all, we are in this business to serve humanity and human beings. Yeah. And they're our guests, so we should be nice to people.
Right. And you're also here, one final thing, your role here with Chime, right?
So I'm the chairman of the board of Chime. Chime is an organization which believes in education for all CIOs and all people who work in health and care. We are doing a tremendous job in elevating the education level, but at the same time, information people how technology is going forward. So that's one of the roles we play.
Well, I think it's very interesting what you're saying, how you're bringing it back to very basic examples. Because in the end, the digital transformation of healthcare is all about delivering better care, right? So I could ask you, what's one of the things in this area that you're currently most excited about?
So I'll just give you one example. Like, my mother is an expert in AI. And how? Because everything I'm about to do, she knows before I do. So in healthcare, they were trying to understand the same thing, like to enable people to make decisions before anything happens, to understand that. So the excitement in this world, especially in the Cloud Expo here, is that the computing power has increased, the storage power has increased, and the connectivity speed has increased. So by that ability, technology is not only in the cloud, but also at the edge. So what that means is that the processing power allows people to analyze, synthesize, to get the right information at the right time for the right person in the right format every time securely. So one of the examples of that will be, like, for example, if you have diabetes and your blood sugar goes down, your pump should tell your phone, which talks to your GPS, which talks to your car, takes you to the closest McDonald's, orders the food for you, you go eat the right size, automatically decreases your insulin, lets your doctor know, don't worry about it, I'm good to go.
Really? Is that a vision you have for this?
Not a vision, this is possible today.
Really?
Yeah.
And implementing.
Yeah, so but we are working on 5G now at Rush, so that has also changed the life. Instead of a slow connection, we can go up to 10 gigabit per second. I am doing at 3 gigabit per second, which is faster than any cable.
So you're citing all of these massive technological advancements, all of these opportunities that exist in the field. Is there one particular challenge that keeps you up at night?
So there are one of the most difficult thing in healthcare is sharing information and collaboration. It's a very difficult thing. All the data is locked in within institutions. And the privacy is also very important. Because if you don't want to anybody to know about you, those days are gone. So in two things that I worry about. One, with the advent of AI, how do we manage privacy? And with the advent of robotics and other automated things, how do we take into consideration their rights? So it's not only humanity. So the bottom line is this, like I always say, be like what my mother says. We have to become better human beings. Mm. We have to practice better ethics, because all of a sudden, things that were not possible in the olden days, Galileo looked at the sky and said, open a new window into the heavens. Louis Pasteur looked down and looked and brought out the eyes and the windows into germ. Big data and AI is bringing an insight and windows into humanity. So when you're asking what I'm worried about is that if everybody knows everything about me, then how do I keep that private? And how do I make decisions in which I'm not judged, in which people don't pass decisions about me by knowing all those things? It's a very sensitive topic, but all these possibilities are there. Bottom line is that we have to become better human beings.
And I think that's a great takeaway message and a really positive note to end this interview on.
Great.
Thank you very much, Afik. Yeah.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.